Had many attacks by them, you know, hundreds if not thousands of them on my body. And I do work with the ones that do come into the light, but most of them don't know about light. All they know about is domination and control. And the domination and control is what they live on and live off of you on with your emotional energies. So anybody have any questions? I love having questions from people. If you do, kind of stand up and speak loud so everybody can hear you.
Have you been on coast to coast before?
I have not been invited on coast to coast, no. Any other questions? Yes. There's many races of aliens. There's hundreds of them, if not thousands, okay? And a lot of the races that you hear about, that people talk about, do abduct you. You have to realize that the common denominator is if they're here to help us, and everybody talks about how the aliens are going to be coming in the future, am I correct, to save the planet. Well, how many more people, how many more deaths do they need in wars for them to wake up to help us? So they're not really here to help us. They're just here to live off of your emotional energy. That's the bottom line. And they can abduct your spirit, which is out of your body. They can take your body also, different energies completely. And they can take you with your spirit on an abduction process. Okay, what you have is you have energies that are... Okay. Oh, perfect.
I was just wondering about the difference between these entities and aliens and source. How?
Okay, the first thing is that source energy does not control anything whatsoever. Okay, so everybody in here, unless you're a clone, okay, I can talk about clones too, but unless you're a clone, if you are a clone, you have no spirit from the source energy in you. That's the first thing. And the clones are now coming around to this planet. You've seen movies about clones, I'm sure, right? Everybody's seen clone movies in the last 10 years. Okay. You have robotic programs put in everybody here from the aliens. I'll do a healing for that to get some of that out of you. So I need maybe one of these ladies here to tell me to do robotic clearing. Okay. Otherwise, I may forget about it. Yeah. Maybe in 10 minutes, okay? So the source energy created everything of light. Light does not control anything. Light gives free will, free choice. The difference is with the aliens, a lot of the aliens were created by the light, but they switched over into darkness, which is kind of what's happened here. When you work with the mind energy, then you get controlled by the mind because the mind works in time. And the time energy is your natal chart. So right away, you can say, how can a planet control me that I don't know anything about, right? You haven't touched it, you haven't lived there, but yet a planet is controlling you. And that means that there's an extraterrestrial force, aliens out there controlling the planet, or that could be an alien controlling you. So right away, you're now in a reality of control. And that's your natal chart. That's put in by the aliens. And with that, they have to have a time sequence, which is the time-based reality. And you know how time works. So I'm going to put you right now into the zero point of time that the aliens created. Remember, in time, it's much like a sine wave. It's turned off and on, off and on, off and on. And so I'm going to put you into the zero point, which people talk about being in the now. But being in the now would be the now of the timeline. So I have to command the energy. I'll count to 10 to do this here. So I'm using light to do this. I'm not using mind energy. This is with your spirit energy working through you to help this clearing out here. Yes?
Before we start any type of clearing or command work, I just had a question regarding how you know between good and bad aliens, and what's an example of how you know you've dealt with, you know, like what's your experience with that? That's so subjective for people.
Okay, the way that you can... discern if something is good or bad. This is with even going to practitioners. You must drop into your heart center. Your spirit's made of light. Your spirit will only draw light to you. It will not draw darkness. It does not know darkness. So it'll only resonate to light. So if you don't go into your heart, you have no way of knowing. I'll do the mind to heart drop right now. Okay? So what I want to do is count from 10 backwards, or from 10 to 1, okay? This you can do yourself whenever you choose to. This is not hypnosis, just a way to command the energy. Remember, you have to command the energy. You can't think of something, because if you think of something happening, now you're then in the mental plane. Mental plane is darkness. So you want to go into the heart center. So you have to tell your body what you want to have happen to it, which is why you want to normally talk out loud or whisper. So here we go. I'm going to drop you into your heart. I'll do this probably four times, and you're going to feel that your mind chatter is released from you. That's the darkness, the mind chatter. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There. So you should all be in your heart center right now. Think of a negative thought or a positive thought. Can you get either one of those? You should not be able to have anything there. It should be peace. When you're in source energy, you're completely at peace. How did I do that? Even the technique that I'm using to do that? Okay, I'm a light being. So I come from source energy. I don't incarnate. So I'm here to help people for the ascension process that happens every 2,000 years. And the energy that people are talking about now is a 2012 event, which they may call the ascension point, which is not. That's going to be the dark side's ascension. So with light, it doesn't exist. The dark side ascension, it will. You'll be abducted on that date if you believe in that ascension point by the aliens, okay? Probably by the Mayan alien race, because they gave you the prophecy. The light has no prophecies whatsoever. The light's only in the now. No predictions, no prophecies. Everything that's works with mind energy will be a prophecy. So how did I do that energy? I just commanded your spirit to drop your awakening thoughts down into your heart center that you can do yourself. Count just count backwards. Yeah, just think of an elevator dropping down. And a lot of people who are very intuitive, very connected to their body, they can actually feel the energy dropping each time I count from 10 down to 1. If I stopped halfway, it would probably be up in here someplace. Very, very simple. So you can do that in place of meditating. Because when you meditate, you are attempting to get into your heart center to be peaceful. But unfortunately, a lot of people, through the meditation process, get out of their bodies. You never want to leave your body, number one, okay? You never want to do astral projection. You don't want to bring entities into you, because once you leave your body, who is protecting your body temple? Nothing. Entities will come into you. Entities are ghosts. They're emotional bodies of people who have passed on. There's alien entities. There's entities that live here floating around, you know, walk in front of a bar or someplace. They'll attach to you, go into a hospital. There are plenty of entities there. Everybody who's died, what you call ghost, there's an entity for that, okay? Living, that have lived in the past. They have the whole history of that lifetime in that emotional body, and they can be attached to you, giving you an addiction or even a physical problem. So anybody have pain in here? Okay? What I'll do now is a clearing for entities that resonate to your pain, and I'll take that away from you. Okay? Here we go. So I have to command the energy again, so I'll count to 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. How does your pain feel? Gone? Okay. Do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Do it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So if the pain is gone or reduced a lot, that means that an entity came into you, resonated to your problem, and gave you the pain in your body. Interesting, huh? Yes? Entities need a life form like yourself to live in. So they lived in a physical body before. The person died. The entity now, the emotional body, left that body looking for a host. And that's what people normally read when you do spiritual readings. You're not necessarily reading their spirit. Okay, you're reading the entities. And you can also be reading the genetics of the person's body. So it's very hard to read spirits or a person's spirit, because a lot of times that energy of that spirit is completely erased after the last incarnation. You might have a resonance to a situation or a location, which is probably because your body genetically has lived in that time frame. Okay? So that's your past lives, yeah. Your past lives is stored inside of your genetics. So you are living the life of your ancestors. What they believed as far as their thoughts are stored inside of them, and you're living that right now in this present moment. And the issues that you're dealing with in this lifetime is only coming forward because they're very detrimental to you, and your spirit, along with the body, would like to heal that and get rid of it out of you, so now you have your life patterns, okay?
Robotic cleansing.
Robotic, okay. So I'll talk about the robotic clearing here, robotic programming. The aliens put on us a robotic type of energy. It's outside of our body, but it controls us. And here we go. So I want you to, I'll work with your neck first, okay? And this I did back in New York, and I had a room of probably 120 people, and almost, I'd say, 105 of those people at least felt the healing. Yesterday, a lot of people felt it. I'd say, you know, a good 100 people at my lecture. So here we go. Just sit there, nothing to do. This is light working with your spirit, okay? If you attempt to use your mind energy to do these healings, trying to figure out what I'm doing or to use a modality that you were taught in the past, it will not work, because light doesn't need any help to do healings on you. It's instant. I only count because I have to count, because your mind wants to hear me do something, okay? So it kind of like satisfies you. But I could just do it like this here, okay? So here we go. We're going to take away energies off your neck. And these are programs that the aliens put on you. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Anybody feel any energy move in their neck? Okay, I'll do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Now we're going to work down to your shoulders. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I'll go down to your elbows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And wrist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And fingers. Want to move your fingers? See how they feel? Get your joints loosened up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. How does your body feel? Feel a little bit looser? Light? Okay, so you are having a program put on you on the outside of your body. This program was being transmitted to you by the aliens somehow. Doesn't matter how they're doing it, it was done, okay? And you're having that results put into your body to have your body being controlled like on a remote control basis.
Everybody.
Now, this is part of the clone training that they're trying to do to the body here. Yes?
Do the aliens come in disguise?
Yes, aliens can come into your bodies. Okay, the aliens can bring forth an alien life form that looks like you here as a clone. They can have aliens walking. There could be a few aliens in the room here. It feels like there's about four or five in here right now as I scan the room here, which is perfectly fine. A lot of the aliens are, you know, do deserve to live here as long as they don't interfere with people. That's the difference. So what you have is the darkness energy. These are creations that are from the dark side with no spirit, okay? And so those type of energies cannot have light put into them. On my website, I have a place that you can go to, which is called the Darkness to Light Clearing, and you can bring the darkness beings, the energies, into light. Because they have, most of the aliens are afraid of the light, because their whole premise on living is to use, you know, domination and control of people. So when they see the light doesn't have that premise. The light is just free will, free choice. But the aliens can't come into the light because the light would destroy them. It'd be darkness. See, what happened on this planet is that the aliens brought all the religions here. And then they gave you the information, which I call the light of the darkness. So they copied true light and fabricated that in the darkness arena. So when you go to a church and you pray outside of yourself, P-R-A-Y, then you are connecting to some alien race that you know nothing about, and now you become prey, P-R-E-Y, to that alien race or an individual of an alien race, okay? Yes?
So many of us are being controlled. How would they allow us to come
here and learn? How would they? You came here one time. You got your nice bus ticket from the tour guide, right? And you came flying in here somehow, and you got stuck. And you got barcodes put on your spirit. You got barcodes put on your on a body. The aliens gave you the bodies here. This is why we all look different. And they stripped us of the consciousness in our DNA so we could not evolve far enough, okay? Because remember, if you were like an alien and you had all that technology, all the wisdom, then you'd be competing with that alien, and then you'd have problems, or they'd have problems with you. So this is why you got stuck here, basically. So they took away everything. They severed your connection to the light, the true light. They gave you churches. They gave you Jesus to pray to and everything else that's there, deities, etc. And that's all darkness energies. When Jesus came here 2,000 years ago, when he lived, he was doing healings to take away your genetic programming inside of your body. And that programming was for the body ascension. When Jesus left here off this planet, those healings completely stopped. There was no conduit for the healings. Why did he leave? He was here for ascension. He was teaching ascension. And then he left. And part of the teachings was basically to get rid of the density stored inside of you, the blockages, the traumas, the emotional baggage that you have stored inside of you from your ancestors. Like I said earlier, you're living the life of all your ancestors. Now your spirit cannot and will not come into those densities once they get activated. A baby is pure. Why is a baby pure in the form of the baby, the energy emitted from the baby? Because it has not started its life path yet. Okay, it hasn't got knocked over the head yet or spanked or hit with pins or something, you know, on diapers or skin in its knees, so that the trauma has not come out that's stored inside of the DNA. Once that starts, then the whole process goes downhill. And so the spirit of the baby when you're first born is 100% typically. And then as you get older, and by the time you reach the age of 10 approximately, you're probably down to maybe 20% of your spirit energy.
And is there anything you can do to save your babies while they're little now? Or while they're
from that? It'll eventually happen to where they meet other people. Maybe somebody hits them or something. You know, it's very difficult to hold that spirit energy. I'd say it's pretty hard. There's too much implants here because they're implanted by the aliens too, just like you are, with time-controlling implants. Yes?
I was just wondering if you could differentiate between healthy connectivity with your ancestors versus them being entities inside your body, because there is a difference in studying with different healers and philosophies and, for instance, like, studying in the past, I've studied with Drunvalo, and he's explained.
Okay. Why would you want to connect to your ancestors?
Maybe your soul purpose.
There's no soul purpose here. Remember, in the light, when you're in the darkness, then they tell you all this stuff about your soul purpose, why you're here, why you came in, what you came here to learn. Okay. In the light, that does not exist. See, because what you're talking about is how you're being controlled by the alien time-framed reality, okay? In the true light, that does not exist. I only talk about true light, okay? True light is you have free choice, free will, instantly. There's no predestined script for you.
So you don't believe in, like, soul contracts or purposes?
Soul contracts, yeah. Do I believe in those? Do they exist? Okay. Yes, of course soul contracts exist. The dark side, the aliens put you into a soul family to have lifetime after lifetime of misery with that soul family to learn something. And that's where you have your spiritual contracts and agreements. And that causes you pain and trauma. All of you here probably know somebody in your soul family. There's probably maybe 10 people that you associate with, and they're all in there to help you, in a sense, grow. That's what they tell you. But they really set yourself up for disaster because they're here to bring forth the energy in your DNA to cause you trauma. The aliens live off of your emotional, traumatic energies. And so as far as a soul purpose, there's no divine order. Remember, the light only works in the now. So you have to remember that. So when you start hearing me talk, just get back to the premise, the light only works in the now, and there's nothing to do with time, and there's no prophecies, because if there was a prophecy, it would be darkness. So all the teachings that you probably have heard about or read about, most of those teachings, if not all of them, are false teachings. It's to keep you trapped here. It's much like the song from the Eagles, Hotel California. You can check out any time you like, but you can never leave. Okay? And that's why you're all here right now. That's why I came back to teach ascension for people. You're here right now listening to me. Not that you came here to listen to me, but you're here right now because you are trapped here. If you had a place to go to in the pure light, you would not be sitting here. And I find it myself very interesting to watch panels who talk about ascension. And they're trapped here. And they're telling you how ascension is going to be. And they've been probably stuck here for 50 to 100,000 years, like most of you people. What do they know about ascension? They lost the last ascension when Jesus came. That's why you're still here. You didn't understand the teachings of Jesus to get rid of your densities outside of your body or inside of your body. To have your body full of spirit energy. Yes?
If we're trapped, would it be conceivable to say that you're trapped as well?
No. I did not come through the Galactic Federation energies, the alien energies, to come here. I came from source energy down here.
So
I'm out of time. I don't live in your reality.
So is any of us have the option of being here to do various missions of our own? As maybe you're on your own mission of spreading the word. We're doing our own thing in our own way.
I would say probably not. What you're talking about is, you know, your life path, if you're here to do something good for people. Yeah, that's all stored inside of you. That's stored inside of your DNA. And inside of your DNA has the programs to make you do what you want to do. That's when you live in time. When you're in time, then you have the problem. What I'll do is take you out of the time-based reality, okay? Here we go. Ready? So one, I'll put you into the zero point that people talk about. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There. Now time has stopped for you. How do you feel? Feel good? The same. Okay, do you feel better? Okay, what it is that everything around you should not be courting you. I'll do it again for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When you're in time, there's energetic cords attaching to your body from everything. When you're out of time, you should feel lighter, you should feel peaceful, but you're still in the time-based reality with zero point, okay? I'll put you now where I live, okay, ready? This is source energy out of time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Feel the shift? Okay, so this is source energy that you're living in right now. No alien interference, and you have free choice, free will. How do you stay here? Good question. You get a thought, you may get taken out, okay? But you can. I'll probably have you in this for a short time, okay? I can hold the energy for a while. But that's a good question. The way you want to get is to get the densities outside of your body, because the body's densities, I mean, inside of your body, that's keeping you trapped here, that has mind-controlling programs on it to get activated at different times in your life because you live in time, those energies get activated. And once they get activated, then you're on a time-based reality. So you want to always stay in the moment. Yes? Yeah, my website is creationlightship.com. I have many online healings there. They're 24/7. And the healings all go through my body to the lightship. So I'm the conduit this time around for healings. The other person on the planet that was not doing healings to help humanity was Princess Diana. She was. So she was from, her spirit was from the lightship. So she was a light being. You can't get caught into how she looked or what she did or what the tabloids said. Her mission was to help humanity, which is what she left here. I won't get into the process about her being killed or anything else. You know, it doesn't make any difference. She left that mark here. Okay, so I'll try to hold you back into this same space here because we're going into, you're getting out of the where I live right now. I'll put you back in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There. Yes. Ah, good question. When you go to sleep, typically because you don't talk to your spirit on a daily basis, right? How many in here today has talked to their spirit? Ah, great. I got some hands. Wonderful. Okay. So that means that you communicated with your spirit. You dropped into your heart. Most people don't do that. So your spirit's waiting and waiting and waiting. So finally, when you become unconscious, it actually leaves your body because, you know, it's been here, done that. So now it left. And then when you wake up, it comes back into your body to attempt to talk to you again. Now what happens is when you're out of your body, who's protecting your body? Nothing. So what comes into you? Entities, ghosts, etc. Okay? And then you have more stuff happening to you, more addictions, more troubles, more problems. You wonder why you're behaving strange a certain day or so. Entities body hop from one to another. So I'll do some entity clearing here again. So think of a situation in your life that you want to have entities released from, maybe an addiction. Okay? So think of an addiction right now, and I'll take those energies away from you. It could be even eating like Fritos or potato chips or something, you know, that you don't want to do. That they love, okay? Or popcorn or, you know, midnight snacks. So here we go. Think of something. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, how do you feel? Feel a little bit lighter? Okay, any tingles? Okay. Tingles. Okay, so what happened is the tingles are from your spirit now coming into the locations that the entities got stuck in or that they wanted to live in. So now your spirit's taking over that energy. Yes, I see a hand straight back here. Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, entities are leaving you, and you're probably feeling them leave you with the densities. Entities have densities, and so they're heavy. What's that? One more? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There. Yes. The purpose is what you choose to do. And your purpose, more than likely, to be what's stored inside of your genetics.
But is that wrong?
No, it's not wrong. It's just that if you get controlled by it, and it tends to take you over, because you should have free choice, free will, every moment. Okay?
But if I feel like it's important, I should continue on that path? Or?
You'd want to go inside and ask your spirit. Ask your spirit if you're being mind controlled to do something.
I don't think I am, but I'm open to it.
Yeah, well, you have to ask your spirit to find out. because your spirit knows. So if you bring anything to you, if you bring anything through the mind energy, by thinking of something to come to you, like you want to invoke something, you're bringing in mind energy. You're bringing in darkness to yourself. Okay? That's where the aliens work. So you have to just strictly work with your spirit and bring energies to you from your spirit, and that'll be light energies. So if you want to go to a practitioner, go to your heart and see if your spirit likes that practitioner's energy, if they're using heart energy. Most practitioners use mind energy, and the mind energy will be connected to stuff. And a lot of people who do mind energy healings are giving you all the energies of the people that they worked on previously to you through the emotions that they're carrying of the entities and the people in their body, and they transfer that onto you. Very dangerous.
But it feels, yeah, I feel comfortable. I feel like I have a spirit guide. I feel like I'm, no.
No such thing as spirit guides. No, no. No such thing as spirit guides. Spirit guides are entities. And the, yes? Once in a while, your spirit could possibly come to you as a spirit guide because you rejected your spirit. Okay? So may pose as something to you that you might like, okay? But typically, voices are entities. If the whole thing, you know, your question is very great, very good, but you have to drop into your heart and then find out where you're getting the information from, because your spirit will never talk to you inside of your head. It doesn't live there. That's mind energy. So if you get it from your heart, then you're in the right place. So, yes. Little orbs?
Orbs, yeah,
just
orbs. They fly around them with incredible precision.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them are really big, and it's actually just wondering what your view on it, because I have them all around me, and they fly towards me, I have hundreds of videos of them in my house.
Yeah, that could be orb energies. It could be aliens moving around, you know, another dimensional frequency.
What's orb energy?
Orbs are what you see, like little round balls. They normally show up at crop circles. They'll show up at UFO sightings, etc. The orb energies, from my experience, are attached to the jellyfish energy that sits on the top of your head. How many here have seen the movie Avatar? Good. Okay. Now, that movie's about mind control. You all know that, right? Okay. So, that the tree in the movie is kind of like the tree of life, we'll say, right, for that planet. And it communicates to everything, okay? Kind of like a big computer. And it has little tentacles that comes down attached to people. And it has a little scouts going out, which are little jellyfish energies in a sense. And that connects to the people. And during the movie, I guess Jake was there and he wanted to fly in this bird. Remember that? And he took his jellyfish tentacles and plugged it into the jellyfish tentacles that was on that flying creature. Looks like kind of like fiber optics, right? Connected it, and what did he say? You are mine now. So it's one life form, and for him, he'd be an alien, right? To the bird, right? He's not a bird. So he is an alien controlling another life form, much like the aliens do here. So the movie's all about mind control.
Matrix is the same way, right?
Mm-hmm. And if you notice, most of the movies that you've seen the last probably 10 to 30 years are all about aliens or about clones. Surrogates is a good movie about having clones, okay? And that's what's going to be happening to humanity here more than likely at 2012 of December of next year. So the people who do believe in the 2012 energy is coming, and it's going to be changing humanity here. They will probably be abducted by the Mayans and other alien races, taking you off a planet, much like you have all the time now happening to you, and in your place here will be a clone of you. Yes. I have not seen very many good aliens that I work with. The ones that I work with, I normally terminate. The light terminates them. Okay? You can look up in your skies and see the alien ship clouds. Most of you are pretty old in here compared to somebody who's maybe 20, okay? So if you noticed in the old days, you have seen clouds, and when you went to school, they said draw a picture of a cloud, and what do you draw? A circular cloud with like a cotton ball, right? Now, how many cotton balls have you seen in the clouds today or the last year? You don't see those clouds anymore here, do you? They're flat-bottom clouds, right? Those are alien ships. The aliens are up in the clouds. The clouds form around these ships. What are the ships doing? They're transmitting to you mind control patterns. And they're transmitting to you and the governments here and everything else these mind control patterns to control you. Why? Because there's a prophecy that's going to happen where they say the end of the time is coming, the calendar's ending in 2012. So they're all coming in here to collect you through abduction processes to do that. Where do they take you? Okay, how many in here have lost your keys? Okay, how many of you have missed a freeway off-ramp? Okay, or maybe you lost something else, you know. It's happened to all of us, right? So what happened during that time? Okay, you have routines that you do all the time, and it seems pretty consistent to you, and you just lose something. Well, chances are that whole time frame that you're living in, at that particular moment, you were abducted. Let's say that you're in your garage, okay, if you have a garage. They took you in your car and your whole garage someplace, and maybe you were playing with something, doing something in your garage, and you moved it, and now it's up in the beyond or someplace in a parallel lifetime. See, parallel lifetimes are alien. They're not something that you should be going into, but we all have parallel lifetimes. It's what I call driving into the billboard. You're driving down the freeway, and all of a sudden, you feel the energy change around you. You might yawn. You might say, this is a little weird, but you don't know about what it is. It lasts for about 5 seconds, and you're completely abducted. But what's in your place? The car behind you maybe did not get abducted, but you did. So what they do is they stop time. Remember, we're talking about time, right? So right now we're here, so you're here. But when you're not here, right, and you're here over here again, where are you when you're not here? You know, because you have a frame, right? So you're on and off, right? When you're off, they can stop everything, abduct it, abduct you, abduct people around you, and then put them back into place, turn time on again, because they're in control of time. Everything looks normal to you. Now, if you're driving your car and you get abducted for, say, five minutes, your ears might pop, you might feel a little strange. The clone that's driving your car now, that got replaced because you can't have the car not there in front of you, you know, or in front of somebody. You can't have the whole scenery disappear, right? So all this is fabricated, okay? And so that clone will have the memory of what's happening. Now, when they switch places, they take that clone's memory and put it back into you, and then you come back down again. Now, a lot of times they don't get the exact GPS location for your car. So how many of you have been driving your car and you all of a sudden you jerk a little bit or something? You go, oh, crap, you know, I'm going off the side of the road, or I'm doing a lane change, I'm going to hit somebody. Or maybe a car all of a sudden materializes alongside of you. How many of you have actually had that happen to you? You look in your rearview mirror and you go, I'm going to do a lane change, and all of a sudden you hear a horn beeping. You go, where'd they come from? Well, they just landed. So what you have is alien race A abducted the car behind you, right? That's not here yet. An alien race B has you, and maybe they dropped you down here, and then all of a sudden the other race dropped you in place, or dropped them in place, and all of a sudden these two energies come together in this timeline, and all of a sudden you go, wow, what happened? Interesting. Yes?
Do Well, I'm wondering how what the alien agenda is with the chemtrails, because there's all these different. Do you have?
I have no idea about that. All I know is when I look at some of the planes that are doing chemtrails, I cannot sense a life, a pilot on that plane. Okay. Could be. You know, I have not got involved with that agenda yet. Yes.
What is the purpose of the abduction? Once we're abducted, why?
Why do they want you?
Yeah.
Okay. You really want to know that?
Yeah.
Okay. First of all, they can take you. I'll talk about parallel lifetimes. This is what we're talking about going into. Okay. So the abduction process is to take you into a parallel lifetime. So they clone everybody around you, looks like you, looks like your friends, everything looks the same, your house, your location, your workplace. And what they can do is fabricate that over again and take you out of that and put something else in your place, a clone. Now, where do they take you? Well, the aliens want to live off of your emotional energy and your trauma. So they can traumatize you. How many here have had bad dreams at night? You wake up maybe in a cold sweat and you go, oh, crap, this is bad. Well, that's happening to you on an alien parallel lifetime. And you just happen to get the bleed through on it sometimes. So it's happening all the time. Deja vu is that. Deja vu is the fact that you just got out of the situation and now you're reliving it over again. And you can be in 100 lifetimes at one time. So what normally happens is one alien race will abduct you. So just think of like a horse race, okay? Maybe like 20 lanes across, right? And they're all identical. And so alien race A takes you for 10 minutes, okay? And all these things are running, playing out the same speed. So they go, okay, we're going to bring you back. So you now come back to the first lane, okay? We'll say A, lane A, right? So alien race B got you. And now it's time for alien race C. So now they take you from that experience of A and put you into C, okay? And then another one takes you off. And this is how the whole thing works. So you're living many parallel lives at one time. Why do they do that? Because they want to live off your emotional energy. They want your spirit. They want the part of you. Remember, they came here to teach you religion. So you have to pray and become prey outside of yourself. And this is how they attach to you. And they want to get your emotional trauma. So the more that, if you don't pray, you're much better, you know, much better off. The worst thing is that if you're sick and people start praying for you, now the aliens know that you have a problem. Now they're after you. Ah, there they are. That person has a problem. They're too weak right now. Okay? So what they want to get is your emotional energy. So if they create more parallel lifetimes running at the same time, just think how many of those lifetimes you can be on and how much trauma they've been taken away from you. Now, what can they do to you on a lifetime? Well, women, they can, give you to take your eggs. You know, men, they can take their sperm. They can deal with your body all different ways. They can make hybrids out of you. They can put you in a slave concentration camp. They do all this stuff. They can eat you. They can put in a clone body part if you miss one. You know, it gets very, very scary. I don't want to make this a scary, workshop, but that's what they do. Yeah, I'm out of time. I do have to deal with them.
How do you prevent abduction?
How do I or you?
Well, everyone.
How do you... Your only chance not to be abducted, which doesn't necessarily work 100% of the time, is to be 100% in your body. Then you have light protecting you.
So if you talk to your spirit all the time and you...
You have to clean out your densities. Okay, remember, let's go back to Jesus' time, okay? So what did Jesus come here to do? He came to teach ascension, right? Ascension is to clean out your physical body of all the genetic programming from your ancestors. And then you can have your spirit come more fully into your body. Now remember, he's talking to adults, not babies, okay? And then you would, then you can take the Bible verses and whatever he talked about. I'm not a Bible student, okay? But, he did talk about everlasting life. Well, that's ascension, okay? Your spirit is eternal, but here it's stuck here. And it's still eternal. but it can't get out of here because of the abduction processes.
So are you here to tell us how to get out of here?
Yeah, get your clearings done. Yes, I'm doing what Jesus did 2,000 years ago. Just that it's probably it's much, much harder because your parents and all your ancestors did not work on themselves emotionally. Remember, your emotion is how the aliens get you. So the emotional problems that's stored in your DNA is your basic enemy. So if your parents would have worked on themselves, had you at a much later, you know, age than what you were born at, you know, for their lifetime, you know, if they were like 60 years of age, let me get some water here, they would have conceived you at their age of 60, and they worked on themselves throughout their whole lifetime, a lot of their baggage would be released, right? Well, just think if your grandparents would have done that, and you go back all these generations, 2,000 years ago. So the problem is that people chose darkness in place of choosing light. They did not clean out their bodies. So most of the teachings now about ascension, which you may go to panels tomorrow and hear people talking about ascension, they're going to tell you to smile at people, be very nice, the planets are coming, the aliens are going to be coming. There's all different theories out there, different alignments going into the fifth dimension reality, etc. None of that's true. That's just mind energy. That's the prophecies coming through. Remember, the light does not channel. Okay, so you get somebody who's doing a reading, and they say, I channel Archangel Michael for my spiritual reading, or I have all these angels around me doing an angel reading or whatever. The light doesn't do that. It'd be in judgment. The light does not judge itself. It cannot channel through anything. And you already have it inside of you. So why are you looking outside of yourself for your answers? So, I'm just telling you to go to your heart. And I'm giving you information. And go to your heart. So let's do some water charging. Everybody have water? If not, there's a cooler in the very back. So how are we doing so far? Did I lose anybody, or I lost a few? Implants go off on people, you know, and yes. Okay.
How can you be in your heart and not do that? It's sort of kind of
okay. And the only way for you to help anybody on healing, okay, the first thing is that I would never recommend anybody to be a healer. Okay, so I guess the first question is, if you're a healer, why am I saying that, right? Because you're compelled to do that, correct? Okay, here's what happens to healers. Most healers die of the physical problems that they healed when they hit the age between 50 and 60. Okay? Now, why do they die of what they healed? Because they got activated in themselves. The genetic programs that people had stored inside of them came to that person. So you deal with somebody who has lung cancer, and you say, yeah, I can heal you. And maybe you're using the light of the darkness. And what I will say, just switching gears slightly here, is that the light of the darkness, the dark side practitioners who use darkness to heal, which is mind energy, can heal normally quicker and faster than the light can. So you might say, gee, is the light not powerful? No, the light only works in the now. The darkness gave you your problems. So the darkness and the practitioners who use darkness can figure out what the problem is instantly, just like curses and spells, and take it off of you. Yeah. DNA programming is darkness. You shouldn't have anything in your body. Your body just needs the genetics to become who you are. It doesn't need you to have the track record of all your ancestors causing you problems. Okay, that's what the aliens gave you.
So
they can't remove it. No, they're using mind energy. No healer can take away your all of your DNA stuff. They may tell you that they're doing that, but they can't.
Well, the answer is similar to your training. It's like
Yeah. You have to go to your heart to find the difference out. Yeah, but your spirit energy does not have enough horsepower to do that type of work. Okay, remember, if you're only 20% in your body, the most you can ever expect is a 20% healing. Okay, and so what I was going to say is your spirit, the way you do healings, if you choose to do that, is you have to go into your heart and run your heart energy to somebody else. Now, your spirit will pick up that energy from that person, because that person's spirit very possibly is not running that energy of wholeness, of source energy inside of it. So you can give it like a little booster shot. But now your spirit's going to take on that energy of that person. Now, that could be manifested inside of you. So you have to heal your spirit. That gets to be more complicated. So the main question that I get from people, they say, well, gee, you know, I'm from source energy. You know, why can't I do this healing? Well, you're not powerful enough, because you're not connected to the source energy that created you. The darkness severed that. So you have enough inside of you to run your body, to be connected to the light. This is why you have past lives here. If you know, the premise, the whole foundation of the light is not to go to one planet forever. It would be ridiculous. So you go to one planet, we'll say, incarnate there, you choose your life form, you go into it. There's no trauma when the life form dies, because you just take the spirit energy out of that life form, and then there's a blueprint for that particular body. And there's nothing, there's no trauma. And then you go somewhere else. Okay, we're here, you're stuck here. So if you had enough spirit energy in your body, you know, you would not even want to be here. But the dark side severed you from source energy to go into the universe of light. That's the problem here. So let's do our water charging here. So take your glass of water, hold it in your hands, and we'll bring in the dolphin energy. And it will help to bring in some nice, peaceful energy for you. Here we go. So here comes the dolphin. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So take about 20 seconds here. Okay. Have some water. See how it tastes. Any comments? Smooth? Fishy? Okay. Does your body like the water? Okay? So it's what you need right now in your body. So since you both have the same water, it's only designed for one of you. Okay? Yeah. So it all depends who. That's why you want to get your own water. Because the light beams will put energy. Yeah, because the light beings only put the energy that you need right now in this moment into your water for healing. Yes, this lady here. That's good. Okay, very good question. Okay, so being in your heart is like baby steps. Everybody should be in their heart all the time. Okay? That will not help you ascend. Okay? Ascension is having your spirit come into your physical body, into all the cells of your body. Being in your heart is just being heart-centered and being out of trauma.
A little girl said to me that if you listen to your heart, you won't have any trouble in your life. But if you don't, you'll have pain in your life.
That's good. Mm-hmm. Because it's a little girl. Yeah, she knows. So I'll do your water here. Yes, go ahead. Yeah, in the light, the ascension time will happen instantly. There's no date on it. You won't have any trauma. A lot of people, they get worried about what's going to happen to their children, their dog, their cat, their parents. It's instant. The whole universe of light is turned off. So that could mean that there's darkness here, okay? And they talk about out of the darkness came the light. Well, that's sort of true, okay? Because in the universe of light, when there's no blueprints activated, it is like in a darkness. There's a void there. But the darkness never created light. At least the darkness that I talk about. Okay, the darkness is a dark side energy, which is a soulless energy. Okay, no spirit. So you have that on one side, and you have light on the other. So the light gets turned off. Nothing exists, period. The earth here will no longer exist. You won't exist. It's going to be a blueprint. And at that point, you have the opportunity with your spirit to re-enter your physical blueprint of your body. And if that physical blueprint is cleared out of your DNA densities, your dramas and traumas, your past life programming, then your spirit can re-enter that and rematerialize your body. Now, if you're only half cleaned out, you can't walk around with just strictly maybe your waist on down, right? Or just maybe your head or a finger or something. So you have to have your whole body cleaned out. This is what the teachings of Jesus are. He came to heal people's sins. That's what they talk about, right? That's their DNA densities. So you get those out of you for ascension. Now, if you can't do that process, and you can't clean your body out according to his teachings, okay, which is the same thing today, then your body cannot be rematerialized. It'll just be a blueprint. And the blueprint will go to the light ship, but stay outside of the light ship. The light ship is what I talk about, creation light ship. So the light ship is a location, we'll say, somewhere, and it's everywhere, but it has to be physical to have manifestations on it. This is where I take people to. So when Jesus said, you're going to the Father or whatever, this is what he's talking about, is the light ship. You just have to change those words, okay, and everything will probably fall into place in your concept of thinking. Now, if you can't take your body with you, then your spirit will go back to what is called a home base energy. And that's where you go to for each incarnation. This is if the light can find you. So the darkness is trying to do, which it did in Jesus' time, they just abduct people off the planet. When ascension time occurs, you go into parallel lifetimes. Then the planet gets turned back on over again. And at that point, you live a life like we do right now. So the earth spirit, since it resonates with your physical body, is allowing you, if you can clean out your body enough, to bring forth your body to where it's going. It already has a blueprint created. Now, in the light, there's no such thing as dimensions. But in our terminology here, the earth spirit is going to 8D reality, number 8. Not 5, but number 8. So you have the opportunity to take your spirit, energize your body blueprint, and go there. Because the earth spirit resonates with your body itself. Because your body is made of the elements of the earth, and the earth has its light in the elements of the earth. You people follow me so far? So if the earth got rematerialized again, which it could do, its blueprint is kind of up for grabs. So we'll say another spirit comes into the earth here and rematerializes the earth blueprint, and it looks identical to this one here. You could not live there because your body resonates to the earth spirit. Yes?
You had mentioned earlier about
Yes. You'd have to work on the emotions that got stored in the DNA that got transferred to you, which would be probably pretty difficult to do. That's why healers die maybe at the age of 60 or less, okay? And people say, gee, this person was a great healer. Maybe he healed, 10,000 people or something, okay? Well, it's very possible. And you go, gee, how could this person that's so great doing all these healings be taken down by cancer or some kind of problem? Isn't the light helping them? No, the light's not helping the healer. Using dark energy to heal. Because they're not using true light. They're not using spirit energy. I watched many healers do their modalities. And you're welcome. One healer that I saw, which is probably pretty common practice, that they would invite somebody up from the audience. Everybody has a problem, right? So they say, okay, anybody have a problem with their right shoulder or something, So naturally you get somebody coming up. And what they would do is they'll take all the energy of the people. So the person will say, okay, send me all your energy, everybody. I want to heal this person. Maybe you've even seen this happen, okay? So what everybody in the audience is doing, thinking that they're giving love energy, they're giving mind energy. So what's in mind energy? All your emotional baggage, right? So now this healer is now collecting all this gigantic tons of energy from people because they think they're using heart energy, right? You're going to help this person over here, right? And now the healer takes this big ball of energy and slam dunks it into the person, right? Well, that energy is so strong, being emotional energy, it can actually do some healing. And the person may have their shoulder healed. But what do they get in exchange? They got all the baggage of everybody in the whole room going into that person. Yes.
This particular healer that I saw is staring at everybody.
Okay.
And let's say there's 10,000 people.
Alien abduction.
So that's what he's doing?
Alien abduction, yes.
I noticed that his left side of the space changed, and that it was almost like his eyeballs now on one left on the left side.
Okay, yeah. It just means that you're being abducted and being tagged, okay? Yes.
I have two friends that were abducted, and they were both drug addicts at the time. And they would never go into full detail because, you could tell they were scared shitless.
Of course.
Both woke up with
marks.
Yeah, on their vaginas.
Probably wouldn't matter, because it happens to everybody, unfortunately. Yes?
You mentioned about the chemtrail plane. Did you say you don't sense anything up there? You don't
see he's talking about chemtrails. I don't sense a pilot being on a lot of those planes that are flying the plane. Okay.
Is it happening or not happening?
Well, the chemtrails are real, yes. Why they're here, I really can't tell you. There's a lot of information on it. I haven't checked out chemtrails yet. Okay, what I can tell you is anything that's a natural disaster here is caused by the aliens. That's firestorms, that we have, hurricanes, tornadoes. Any of that stuff that you see is caused by aliens. Okay, yes?
Does that include the species-specific
die-off? What's that again?
Oh,
that are dying off? Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't know why they're dying. Okay, it could be from the chemtrails even. I don't know. That's not my agenda. My agenda is to help people to get rid of aliens here. Yes.
Do
you want to feel it?
Yeah.
Okay, ready? Here we go. So what's going to happen here for your mind to understand? The Earth Spirit is going to allow you to feel its blueprint on eighth dimensional reality. Okay, it's choice. Remember, in their light, there's free choice, free will. So it's allowing me to bring the energy in to do that. Okay, ready? So I'll count to 10. 1, 2. two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. There. How's it feel? Peaceful? Yes. Okay, yeah. In light, there's no such thing as dimensions. There's no hierarchy. Light is light. There's no higher self. There's no lower self. There's no medium self, you know. There's no angels. There's no nothing. It's just pure light. There's no differentiation of light there. Okay. When I bring in different energies inside of my body, which I've probably had five so far, if you notice that I change a little bit, okay, these are different light beings coming in to, in a sense, read you to find out what I have to talk about next, okay? So this is the way my body works, okay? But there's no such thing as a difference in true light. Yes? Okay, the prophecies are from the darkness, and those are all true. Because the darkness gave you a script to follow, okay? So your option is not to believe or not to get connected by the aliens for that, okay? So just know that it's another day. And I do have on my website a disconnection for the 2012 ascension process, which you could do if you wanted to do that. I can't recall what the cost on it is, but there is a thing to take you off of the 2012 abduction scenario. The light will find you. See, what happens at ascension time, even the dark side ascension that we're talking about right now, is that the light has to look for you to connect to you to find you. If you're not here, they can't find you. So there has to be a trace of you. So they would actually find you now, so that if you do get abducted, they can pull you back again and take you out of the dark side universes.
Will people know they're abducted or they won't know?
You wouldn't even know. What I'll do is a timeline crash right now for you. Well, this is a very good thing to do. The cost on it is, I think it's $20 for a week, and you can do emotional situations. So you get abducted because you have emotional problems. We all have emotional stuff, right? At least one or two, maybe. So what you do is you put in an emotional situation on my website. It's 24/7 active all the time. And we'll do one for fear, okay? Now you're going to feel a change in your body. Now, the fear energy is how you have been abducted and maybe abducted now, possibly, with fear, because they have to get an emotional situation to abduct you. If you don't live in emotions and you don't run that negative energy, then they can't find you, and they don't want you because they live off of your emotions. The more they can push that button of emotions, the more they want you. That's their gasoline, okay? That's their life force energy. So here we go. I'll crash a timeline for fear. Ready? I'll count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There. What do you feel? So, feel a little better? Okay, so this timeline now is crashing. This timeline goes across everything on this planet, everywhere, okay? And whoever's on the timeline with you, living in a parallel lifetime, is being taken off of that timeline. Think of it as looking at a bridge, you know, a really long bridge. And at the far end, it's now disconnected and kind of crumbling. Everybody on that's now being taken off of that. And the alien race right now, or the aliens that were controlling that timeline, are terminated. The aliens should not even be here on this planet. You know, the ones that are controlling you, okay? There are aliens that live here. That's perfectly fine if they don't, you know, infringe upon your free choice, free will, which is what the light is. This planet was made from light, and it's been taken over by the aliens, okay? And the people that live on the planet now tune into those dark side energies, because people choose darkness, mind, okay, more than the heart. You understand that, right? So people choose darkness. It's not that you're, you know, like the lady was saying about the child, right, about, you know, being in peace energy, basically, in love energy. But the aliens give you that traumatic situation that you're going through, and they love that energy. So if you don't live in peace and harmony, then they can abduct you through your fears and anger and everything else. So the timeline now is crashing. So what you're doing is you're taking everybody off the planet who is on that particular alien race timeline. Okay, now I'll do one for anger. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There. So you will start to feel your body change because you're on that timeline living a parallel lifetime right now having problems, okay? And that gets put back into this timeline where you live in the now. Remember that they can just be a few milliseconds one way or the other in the timeline because they control time. You guys understand that completely, I hope, about how the aliens control time and they change time and they can take you ahead of time, behind time. Okay. In the moment, there's no such thing as time, but when you're on a timeline, they can change the time. They can take you 1 millisecond and change the timeline. They can take you and displace you ahead or behind time, okay? So you could be on, within maybe 1 second of your time here, you could be on, you know, 10,000 alien timelines. And you still think that you're here. And they can do things to you, okay? And they can also sell that time space, like time sharing, you know? And so they can sell that to another alien and say, oh, yeah, I paid, you know, $500 for this timeline for 5 minutes, and I'm going to sell a piece of that to another alien race for maybe $100 or something, you know? And now they got you, okay? So it gets to be kind of complicated, kind of sci-fi, but you can feel the results here. Okay, let's do one for sadness, okay? Here we go. Another emotion, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There. Now, these timeline crashings could take up to an hour to do. So you might feel a little strange for maybe an hour after this here. Some timelines crash within 5 or 10 minutes. Some take an hour. Some could be even longer. So when they do crash, you start feeling like, wow, this is different. I feel freedom. When the thing finally ends, you're going to feel much better. Yes, this lady? Yeah. I'm here. So, you know, I have a physical body like you. Out of time, I would say probably yes. Uh huh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. She wanted to know if anyone else is on the planet that I know of that live in source energy. And I would say probably not. I'm the only one that I know of, besides Princess Diana. Yes?
Aliens, are they part of the creation of light or they're not?
Okay, yeah. Some aliens, you know, just like all of you. How many of you have negative, bad thoughts, okay? That's darkness, even though you have a spirit inside of you. So the aliens could have sold out part of their energies because they wanted to become in control of other things. So their main premise is to control and manipulate, okay? And they could have a spirit in them. They could have been created from the light, but they sold out, just like we did here. Now, there are aliens. The true aliens do not have a spirit. Those are the really bad ones. And the real bad ones are the ones that are trying to come into here. That's what you see the horror movies about, okay? Remember, there isn't too many good alien movies out there. Are there some good aliens? Yeah, I have seen some that flipped over from darkness into light, yes, but not too many. I would say of what I have seen, maybe less than 0.1% have switched into the light. They don't have names. All we have here is maybe like 100 different names of aliens, and there's thousands of them.
So, non-duality.
Yeah, the darkness created duality. Yeah, so that's what you have is a charge of duality. That's what they created.
How would you know if you see one? By the eyes? I heard by the eyes.
A different energy. Okay. I can talk about how much time do we have left? Anybody have?
15 minutes.
15, okay. So a lot of the movies now are talking about clones. We mentioned that earlier, okay? So the clones will be replacing the humans. And the clones don't last very long, typically. A lot of the movie stars that you see in the different movies have had cloned bodies, okay? So you can look at people that look like they had a makeover, they look younger, okay? I won't give any names, but there's quite a few of them out there. And you wonder, gee, how could that person have that? And then you have people who have the plastic surgery who don't know about going down into the underground here and having that work done, okay? Remember, there are underground cities here. You know that. If you don't know that, they're here. You can go from L.A. to New York in an hour, okay? And so I won't get into that stuff. That's other stuff. You know, that's not what I'm here to talk about. But there are underground cities, and people live down there. Some people want to live down there and bring a clone up here, and they can control the clone, and the clone can look younger, because what will happen is after a while, the clones start to fall apart. A clone typically has about a two-week memory. That's all that you really need. If you look upon your own life, all you need to know is about 2 weeks in the, you know, from the past, right? All the rest is probably going to be drama and trauma. You just need to know how to start your car and how to eat, right? So 2 weeks is plenty. And the clones have the artificial intelligent bodies in them, so they're self-learning. But the clones do break down and fall apart. And when they start falling apart, then they can have another clone brought up in their place and look better. The new clones have the eyes that are very, very bright looking. Look like glass eyes in a sense, with light coming out of them. They have an artificial spirit, but a true clone you can look at and they'll have no body energy. And normally a true clone, since the alien races are creating, you know, these clones, they want to bring up the best specimen. And so they'll create somebody that looks perfect. Clones should not be here, typically. That's what the aliens want to do here, because they want to get rid of, you know, humans and put in clones with the robotic programs. So you may have watched on TV, it's kind of scary for me. I watched this one program. I don't watch much of TV of anything, and I don't read any books, but on the History Channel, and they're showing the soldiers that are in China doing the goose step, and boy, that was scary looking, but they're all controlled that way. You gotta figure out how do they get everybody, maybe 1,000 people, to march the exact same way, okay? Well, so I won't go too much further into that, but that's what they're doing, is alien stuff. World War II was a alien war, probably out there in the cosmos there, and it got transferred down here. So you had the alien race that created the Japanese species here. We'll call it that, okay? Then you had the German species, right? They got together, made an alliance, right? So we had World War II. So those two alien races wanted to take over the other alien races that live here, okay? And somehow that's what happened. That's part of the stuff. They're training you for that. Remember the Verizon commercial that came out, you know, the droid with the mechanical arm? Now, why would they show that? You know, think about that. It's to condition you. Once you figure out or see something, then it comes into your mind, the darkness, right? Light of the darkness energy. And you understand that now as being real. And maybe after 10 years, you say, oh, this is reality here. Because you've already been conditioned for it. So you had the mind implants go off. How many here, you know, when I listen to sports, which I don't listen to that often, but you listen to like a football game and you hear the background noise, sounds all the same, doesn't it? Yeah, well, isn't that strange? Okay, question, yes. They're the same light beings.
Okay, who are they?
They're not a who. They're energies of light. that have chose, okay, yeah, on the light ship they have a body. They manifest a physical body, and the physical body is what they're using to do healing work with us, because they have to have a means to work with you. Yes?
Is there some way you can protect yourself, like, say, stones or anything that you can do to wear garlic? I don't know.
It would be nice. Your only protection is to get fully into your physical body with your spirit. That's your only protection. And I don't know, after you have that done, you could probably still be messed with, but not too much. Okay. Yes? Yes, uh-huh. So they had an alliance out there.
Right, they have the alliance, right?
Okay.
So now, like, I'm seeing in my mind a middle ground, which was the U.S. British or whatever, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
they probably did not want to interfere until, you know, there was a lot of people killed. So it was like genocide. Okay? So on the good side?
Yeah, on the good side, said, hey, we can't make it.
Yeah. So, yeah, on the good side, we'll say yes, okay. But remember, they probably did not want to have the humans controlled by another alien race. So they're still having their control issues.
Right, so there were multiple groups that got together.
Mm-hmm.
And then the two German companies
that. Yes. Yes, uh-huh. And what happened? The people that died in, you know, pain. The alien race has got, you know, the pain energy from those people and their families. And, you know, the bottom line was they wanted to become a controlling faction here, you know, to control the Earth. And the other alien races said, hey, you know, we're losing our control, so we better get our energies together and make our alliance, right, to fight the other alien races. So we actually had an alien war here with many different aliens. Because every one of you, typically, if you have a different skin color or different body appearances, you're from a different alien race. So a different body agenda. So what we have here is one major blueprint for all of our internal organs, okay, and our bone structure, typically, okay, and the way the body works. So that's why you can go to a doctor in a different country and they can say, oh yeah, we have these charts here and this is how it works, right? Well, but we have different skin colors and different traits, and that's from different alien races. So somehow the initial pool of the body itself was sold out to different races who wanted to make the body look different, okay? And if you look at the black people, they're the ones that excel in sports. So that alien race that made the black people put maybe extra muscles or whatever into that body to make them excel. And then all the non-black people didn't like that initially. If you go back, you know, 50 years ago, we'll say, and when a black person went on a sports team, and they were like, you know, for me, looking at the biggest joke was when Hitler had the Olympics over there and that black person won, you know, and man, what a thing that was for him, you know, because they wanted to have a bunch of white people from that alien race rule everybody. And then they had all the mind-controlling programs put into those people to do that. And that goes on today. It's the same process. It's all alien control agenda with mind control. Now we have the ship clouds above our heads, the flat bottom clouds. Yes?
Isn't all of us here made from aliens?
Yep, your body was brought here. The original body was of light, okay? Because light has to come into light. Your spirit will never come into a body that would be created by the darkness, because there's no resonance there, okay? Because it has to resonate to all your cells. If it wasn't created from light, it can't come into it. Your spirit does not know darkness. The light does not know or understand darkness. It has to figure out what it is in order to battle it, to get rid of it. But it doesn't know darkness.
Is it possible for any of us here to be where you
Boy, I don't know. You know, initially, when you were first created, you were like I am, we'll say, with my spirit, okay? And then you left to have your experiences in the universe of light. You maybe had billions of them. And somehow you got stuck by going to the wrong agency or whatever, and you got sent down here. And I don't know what happened. I'm just trying to help people get out of here.
Does awareness help you shun these forces or these?
Not always. Remember, they don't care if you say yes or no to anything. You know, you really have no choice. That's the sad part. So let's bring in some peace energy. Get out of the darkness here, what I'm talking about. So what I want you to remember, okay, when you leave here, you have your mind full of information about what Ron said, okay? What I want you to remember is you have to go into your heart center to understand who you really are, and that's your spirit, okay? And your heart center with your spirit there will give you your guidance. Never go outside of yourself. That's the darkness energy. That's the mind energy. That's the alien controls that's going to abduct you and find out about you and tell you different things. And the light never channels. It can't channel. If the light were to channel, then it would have a way that it could be misinterpreted, okay? And so, you know, you have to realize that you have it all within you. You have everything. You just need one page in one book, and the one book would say, go within. That's all that you need. In a sense, yes. Uh-huh. And your body has its own consciousness, and so does your spirit have a different consciousness, but you want to merge them together. Remember, just the one book, go within. And don't go outside of yourself for information and stuff. It might be good to get, but remember, you might get hooked up too. Okay? So let's bring in some peace energy. So I'll just command the energy by using the word stronger now. So stronger. Stronger, 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 stronger. In fact, I'll just say something. When you first came in here from the last presentation or the people that were in here during the day or whatever, did you feel how dense the energy was when you walked into this room? Okay, and once I started talking, it all went away. That's light coming in here, okay? I'm not saying those people are bad or anything, just that the energy was dense, okay, heavy. I could say it was mind energy, okay? And mind energy is heavy energy. So here we go, peace energy. Stronger, 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 and stronger there. How's that feel? Feel good? So I have a website, creationlightship.com. I have healings on it. We have literature probably in the back here, or go to my booth, number 206. The healings that I perform on the website, the energy runs through my body continuously. What you want to realize is that whatever I have on the website is run by the light ship, the light beings, and they come into your room and they work with you. And the healings that I have is just basically a one-time healing. And what you want to get first is an emotional clearing. So what I'll do for you all is to clear away a density that you're dealing with. So think of a traumatic situation that you had, and let's take it away from you instantly right now. So just think of something, everybody. And you'll have one. Okay, it's gone. Look at it now. You're still going to be able to see it, but it'll be really low in energy, if not released from you completely. So that's an emotional clearing. I'll do a feeling body clearing. Ready? Think of a situation. There, it's gone. Normally, I'll count down, but I'm just doing what I would do 2,000 years ago. Okay? So what I do on the website, that the work is instantaneous. No processing whatsoever. It's taken away from you instantly. The light ship takes your body, gets all your energetic bodies up, and clears that energy from you instantly. And they work in the no-time reality. They work in the true now, not the off-point in the time-based. Okay, they work in the now. So if you do get more into your heart center, you must get a day planner. because you'll start losing track of time. What else should I cover? Anybody have any ideas out there? Yes, this. You won't have feelings in your heart center. You have discernment. When you're in your heart, you have peace. You never have any type of feelings in your heart center. Nope. That's emotional stuff. That's what the dark side gave you. The dark side told you to go to your heart to feel the love energy, to feel happiness, to feel this and that. When you're in true heart energy, there's no such thing as that. That's emotional. That's duality. Remember, when you deal with the duality energy, you have to come into balance. So if you deal with an energy of sadness, eventually that sadness energy will bring you into an energy of maybe happiness, and then from there you're going to go back maybe into balance, into zero, okay? Because you're going to be always trying to achieve a zero balance. That's what the dark side does. In true light, there's no such thing as that. There's no duality energy. And also, in the true light, the law of attraction does not exist. That's a dark side energy also, the law of attraction. Okay? Because you have to hurt somebody or cause a problem in a closed-based reality of that in order to bring your good to you. So people in the New Age movement say, gee, yeah, I just put out, I asked for Archangel Michael to find me a parking place. You probably have heard something like that, okay? And lo and behold, man, you come up there and there's a parking place. So what actually happened? The aliens had to take your thoughts, okay, and go to somebody in that store and take away their free will, free choice to walk out of that store to move their car so you can find that parking place. Very interesting. That's the law of attraction. So in true source energy, you're manifesting all the time in your heart center, and things will come to you naturally. So when I do these talks, a lot of times I'll take people and their current belief systems that they were taught, I kind of like shred them, okay? Because you have to get a whole different belief system in the light, because you've been taught darkness, and that's all that you know. And once you get into your heart, then you use discernment from your heart to find out what you want to do next and who to go to and who to see. And the dark side energies, the mind energy, will give you the sensations of everything that you're dealing with. It'll give you the thrills, but you don't have peace. You have the emotional roller coaster ride. So you want to have discernment. And when you do get very, very happy, or you're very, very sad, the aliens want that, and they live off of that energy from you. It's an energy. It's an out-of-balance energy. Remember, you're in duality. How do you go to your heart? Here we go. I'm going to drop you down into your heart again. So what I do is on my website too. You can do it yourself. This is just a gift that I can give you, a little tool. I can only give you two tools. This is one of them. And I'll give you the other one. So here we go. Count from 10 to 1 backwards. And just know that you're commanding your spirit. Remember, everything in healing is a command. And your spirit has to have that command to do anything, because your spirit always sees you as perfect. The light does not judge itself. Okay? So you have to command something to get it to change. So what we're doing is commanding your spirit now to take your thoughts, the mind chatter, and drop it into your heart. Remember, the laws of the darkness copy the laws of the light, if you want to use that term. Everything works the same. Okay? Just that we live more in darkness, which is the control stuff. So here we go. 10-9-8-7-6-5-4-3-2-1. 10-9-8-7-6-5-4-3-2-1. 10-9-8-7-6-5-4-3-2-1. 10-9-8-7-6-5-4-3-2-1. 10-9-8-7-6-5-4-3-2-1. There. Now you're in your heart center. Now what else I can teach you or give you as far as a tool, I can only give two tools basically right now that I know of, is your life force energy. So what you can do now is everybody can stand up. And what I want you to do is to put your hands facing each other, palms facing each other, and just go in front of your heart center. And go slowly, and you're going to feel your, let's say, your chi energy. It's going to be like compressing a ball of energy. And kind of move your hands in slowly, and your body will tell you where the energy is, okay? And then because you want to work with your physical body, all your cells, you want to say an affirmation. Very simple. I now increase my life force energy. So say that. Move your hands apart. Okay, we'll do it now. I now increase my life force energy. Say it out loud. And now bring your hands in, and you're going to find that they're further apart. Right?
Yes.
Lo and behold, okay? So what happened? You brought in more spirit energy into your body. Say it again. I now increase my life force energy. Put your hands apart. And sample again and see where you are. Good, okay. I now increase my life force energy. And you can put your hands on if you want now. I now increase my life force energy. 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 Five more times. I now increase my life force energy. 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 Okay, you can sit down. How do you feel? We're charged up? So you have more spirit energy in you right now.
So affirmations do make a difference.
A command does.
A command does,
yeah.
So
a little bit different, yeah. Uh-huh. Remember, you have to command your spirit to do something. You can't command something outside of yourself. Then you're bringing in darkness. So how's our time getting to be?
We're over time.
Okay. So anybody in here next? I believe there is, right? So what I could do is maybe meet you outside the room here if you want to talk more for, you know, a few minutes or whatever, ask questions. I do have pictures at my booth. If you want to get one, I charge $10 for them. I have different masters and stuff. I'll bring in the light beams from the light ship right into those pictures. I have Jesus there and Mother Mary and different things. And you can use that like on your altar. People love it.
Where's your booth again?
Booth number 206. We have the light infusion chamber. You want to go into that to have healings. It's wonderful. So, thank you, everybody. Blessings.
Thank you.
Okay.